Hello, everybody. Welcome to Obduction. This is Inferiority Complex. We are not playing Star Trek Online this time. We are playing through Obduction. We're going to start first in a possibly long series of videos as I try to make sense of this game. Cyan, the company that produced this, have had a long history of producing the most amazing games ever. Very rich in story and no possibility of death or dying. There's no bad guy so much to shoot or whatever, just a huge puzzle to solve. And of course, as you're trying to solve that huge puzzle, there are smaller ones. Well, you can see a resume game is highlighted here. Now, I did start a game. I just wanted to see how this would run, if it was going to be okay on my computer system, because the system specs for this game are actually some of the highest I've ever seen. They're not too bad, but I was just a little bit worried that it wasn't going to run too well on my system. We are going to start a new game, of course, and our name is Inferiority Complex. There we go. Oh, it doesn't let spaces. Oh, there we go. Navigation type. Now, free roam is using the WASD keys, as you might expect. Point and click, in the tradition of Cyan's games, Mist, Riven, Mist 3, Mist 4, even though they were actually somebody else that made them. Mist 5 was a game where you could, it was the first Mist game where you could actually wander to your heart's content. And of course they had Uru, which was a spin-off from Mist. And Character Shadow, we're just going to leave that in off. There's no point really to keep that going. Anyway, let's put this to free roam. And the loading screen is very different to anything seen before, I think. I'm not aware of any loading screen which looks anything like that. Okay, here we are. Escape brings up the menu. And as you can see, oh, we have a photo. Oh, can't view it. It's a photo I accidentally took earlier on, playing through the other, just to see how the game worked. Right, so here we are in the woods, and we have a storm coming in. Let's go for a wander.
We all lost everything. Everything but our stories. And they shouldn't be forgotten. I was 3. It was April of 1983. Cecil, it was 1870 for you. Sam and Vera, you tell it like it was yesterday, but it's been 62 years since you saw that last of light.
Okay, a bit crackly on the audio there. Oh!
That light. That's where all of our new stories began. Streaked across the sky, mesmerizing, but unnerving. Even in daylight, Joseph, you said, was gloriously bright. But in the twilight, it was spellbinding. Whether it was in the deep woods like Cecil, or right outside town like Jane and Jenny, we were drawn to see more.
Whoa.
spirit, you said you recall smiling. Some of you were alone. I wasn't. My dear grandma, God bless her, rejoiced as if some forebearer of misfortune. Grandma lifted me from the carriage on the porch and walked into the yard so we could watch it unobstructed. None of us understood, but, well, we followed, and we all felt some kind of trepidation, and yet, attraction. As we approached it approached us.
I don't like the sound of that.
You all remember, there was no turning away.
I have no control.
It advanced, almost like purposefully.
What is this?
Slowly until, well, found us, each of us. We should tell these stories because it saved us and...
Okay. Appears to be the whoa. It's daylight now. We're no longer outside. The trees seem to be embedded in this rock. Where are we? We can't go that way. Lantern. Can you do anything with the lantern apart from light up this little wee hole? Oh! It's like an empty pod now. Well, as is expected with a game from Cyan, just like Mist and Riven and Uru, we're left wondering where we are, how we got here, and if we'll ever find our way home. No clues, no information, nothing. Just nothing. Absolutely no clue whatsoever. Pretty sure I found a key combination for running somewhere. Let's have a quick check. Let's turn the audio down, actually, the master volume, because it seems quite loud to me. Controls, here we go. Run, shift, okay. Okay. Ah, there we go, that's better. Can move more quickly. What's this? Welcome to Hunrath. Ooh, a button.
Hello, bonjour, ciao, hola, hallo, shora, ni hao. Welcome to Hunrath. My name is Yosef. I am the mayor here. You are most probably a bit confused and disoriented. But let me reassure you, everything will be fine. You're not the first to go through this experience. The others who have come before you will help you adjust. Follow the trail to the house with the white picket fence. Fali will meet you there and introduce you to your new life here.
Okay, so that's making out like that's me stuck here forever. I did notice amongst those the greetings Shora, which is the Dunny word for hello. So obviously this takes place in the same universe as Mist and Riven and whatnot, but it's just never ever going to intersect, obviously. I'd imagine that we're just... there's no way we're going to have any of that. Happening. White picket fence, here we go then, there it is up there. Whoa! My computer seems to be maybe not coping so well with the graphics on this. I might need to lower the graphic settings. Farley's Communication Center. Okay, well, that seemed very much like there was one message left for me, and then a different one recorded over it. So, there was a battle. CW. Who's CW? Oh, door's locked. Do not approach anything that even remotely resembles this diagram unless it has been disabled. Looks like a tetrahedron. No, not a tetrahedron. Oh, a dodecahedron. Not why I call it a tetrahedron. Oh, boarded up door. Windows open, can I get in? No. Darn it, that's the... oh, hello. Oh, all the windows are open. I must be able to climb in a window, surely. You want to let me climb in a window? Come on, come on, come on, I want to climb in a window. Oh, hello. There's a shiny thing there. Oh, something's going blimmy, bling, bling, bling. Something's blinging. Shiny, shiny, shiny. Right, what's this? Hey, toy fire engine. Seem to do much. It's just there for the fun of it. Well, that's a dead end. There's obviously there's a path along there or something like that. Can't get up there though. Let's go exploring! Hey! Hopscotch! Oh, whoa! Oh my goodness! Graveyard! Margaret Hartnell, Anna Jackson, Daniel Hartnell, and these wooden bits on front of the graveyards, the gravestones even, suggest that these graves have been used again. Limited space to bury people, so they have to use the same graves. Benjamin Sims, Henry Hartnell, wow, 18-something to 1895. Looks like the Hartnells have been here a long time. This one's blank. Why is this one blank? More graves up here. Oh, even more graves up here. Who's this? Mary Hartnell, 1815 to 1884. John Hartnell Sr., 18-something to 1881. Okay, so people have been here a long time. Daniel Hartnell. Carol Hunrath. Wait, welcome to Hunrath. Is it named after him, or is he named after the place? John Farley, Robert Hartnell. Again, there you go, you've got the grave is already there, and the new name plate put on the front. The grave has been reused, and the same thing happening over here, and they're even preparing to reuse the grave. Look, they've got two empty spaces. Luther Roscoe, Ida Hartnell, lots of Hartnells. They're obviously the Hartnell family. All part of this. That is weird. I am it's like there's a border. Can I go through it? No, I can't go through it. Okay. Let's go exploring more. Nope, let's see where that red light is. Like a laser beam. Oh, train tracks. Ah, mine tracks. Going somewhere that they doesn't exist anymore. No, still can't go through. It was worth a shot. Okay. That lever probably just switches the points on the track. I see no reason to continue with. Okay, they're glowing red. Whoa! What is that? Something like what this planet passes for insects? Hartnell Mercantile. Okay, so Hartnell Mining Company. Okay, so the Hartnell family were obviously pretty busy here. And we have some steps to go up. The tree.
This is the tree. It has been here in Hunrath for as long as anyone can remember. Its health is intimately tied to everything in our little greenhouse. Cell we live in, our ecosystem. It has provided many surprises over the years, including some interesting seeds that you will learn more about. Many have postulated, yet we really know very little about its origins. But we do know it should be cherished and protected.
Okay. There's a crane there. What's around here? This door's going to be locked, isn't it? Oh. Oh yeah, you can actually see the lock. Oh, hello, we can see in there. Nothing to see though. There's the tree. There's some places underneath. How do I get down there? Okay, I don't know how I get down there, but never mind. Let's keep going around. Ah, water tower. Watering the tree. Okay. Supports on that track have broken. Here we go. Backgammon. Where is everyone? Okay, so we've got a boulder in the way, can't get through there. It's kind of disappointing. These levers do just do the points, don't they, on the track? Yeah, they do. Okay. What's this? Downtown Hunrath.
We have a healthy, thriving community here, as you can see. Our garden was planted years ago and has supplied plenty of food for many generations. The buildings around town serve multiple purposes, including housing, schooling, and storage. I'm sure you have run across a number of folks already. Many were brought here, like you, and some actually were born here. We all feel we are a part of the whole.
Oh, it's the same notice as before. Welcome! And everything's boarded up. Nope, not welcome. This door's open. Hello. Let's have a look in here. Armchair, card game, can't interact with anything, briefcase, nope, a couple of pots, a pen, nope, can't interact with that, nothing going on here. Oh. This looks like the other side of the boulder that was in my way. So it's not a boulder. It's, well, I don't know what it is. It's like a shell for something. Something big. Can't go through here. Nope. Light bulb. Okay. Anything on here I can do? Backer reward item. Looks like Lily, who backed the game on Kickstarter, really likes her dogs. Presumably that was someone called Lily who chose this as her backer reward item. No doubt we'll probably find more of them as the game goes on. Frisbee! Wee cart. What do we have here? Nothing especially interesting. Let's go further. Yep, Yeah, okay, it looks like this is the other side of that mine. There we go. Yep, okay, so we've got that big spherical ball. Okay, the fence is in the way. Not much to do over here. Or is there? Another little cart thing. Definitely indicative of children, because that's the sort of thing a child would use, isn't it? An adult would have a box like this. What do we have here? Potatoes? I don't know. Gardening tool, rake. The plants are withered and dried. Whatever happened here happened a long time ago and there's nobody left. Oh, hello. Doorway. Oh, propeller. From an airplane, obviously. Oh, hello. Oh. It moves. Meh. Nothing happening. What's happening in here? Ah, locked door. Should have expected as much. Blocked off mine. What is that? It's a blue laser beam. Can I squeeze past them? Is it lethal? I can get past it. That's nice. That's good. Let's have a look here. Nope, nothing going on. Okay. There's a cart up there of some description. Ah, that's the thing that's firing the blue laser. Can it be lowered down onto the track? And then driven around the track, perhaps? To do something, do stuff. There's another one of them bugs. Okay, so at first glance, this place is very, very small, actually. There's not much going on. What's in here? Hey, another backer reward item. Oh, hello. What's going on this way? Okay, so the waterfall is powering this. Let's go up and see what's going on. Okay, so that's the first thing we've actually been able to do. Door again, no surprise there. This early in the game, I'd expect a lot of locked doors. Ah! What does this do? Can I do anything to it? Nope, not by the look of it. Oh, is that Earth? Maybe not. Dunno. Okay. Nothing exciting going on at all. Oh, we didn't go up this way. What's happening up this way? Yikes. Not especially fond of heights. I'll be looking down on these. Oh, it's computer generated, but gee whiz. Something really weird goes on in my head about heights. Hello. What do we have here? I'll tell you what, I've got an itchy ear. That would happen when you're wearing headphones. There we go. Right. Whoa, something changed. Oh, did this thing open? Oh, I've done the waterfall. We have a waterfall. Wow, you can see quite a lot of things. There's stuff on the other side of that. Damn. There are things over there. You can see more tracks right now. I don't know if you can see my cursor in the video actually. I think you will be able to. Circling to the screen, there's a track running there as well. Must be able to get over the other side. Okay, let's go back down. See what we've done. Oh no! This waterfall shut down. Can I still get back down? Hope so. Don't want to be stuck up here. Yay! You want the bit, I can't go back up now though. Oh no, hopefully I don't need to turn the waterfall off. Right, let's go in here. Hello? That's citrus.
It's a bad time to be arriving here. You should listen to me. I'm going home. Maybe it's good timing for you. You might spend a lot less time in this prison than the rest of us has. Alrighty, maybe it's good timing for me. No more waiting around. I guess I could do it all on my own if I had to. Well, could speed things up a bit with your help. First off, you should know that this whole place has been batting down for that old Carfin Mofang battle. We gotta get everything unbattened. I got me a bit of power here, but I'm gonna need it all. If you can concern yourself with that, get all the power lines on. I'll be working on my devices. Now, let's get the hell out of this place.
Okay. So he looks like he's been here a while. He's doing stuff in there. He's not going to let me in. But he's asked me to get the power lines on. How do I do that? There's a power line. I assume that's a power line. Follow the cables. It's a good plan. Found that out in The Last of Us. Follow the cables. The Last of Us, a good game, by the way. If anyone ever gets a chance to play that, play it. It is brilliant. Okay. Goes up there, so I need to get over there. What does this do? Don't do anything. Wait. It pulls that cable in. I wonder if it didn't do anything, but if this side is down, it might do something. Let's try again. Whoa, yes! Okay, looks like that's open for good, which is, no, it can't be right, because that looks like I've got to be able to get across the top at some point. Never mind. Let's go through, have a look around. Hello. Okay. See what we've got through here. Why can't I get into the river? Somebody's been going for a swim and they obviously didn't come back for their clothes, so that would suggest the river is dangerous. Do not go in the river. Back a reward item. A milk churn? We have another one here? No. Washboard, hammock. Somebody was obviously relaxing. Oh, campfire. This looked like somebody has piled stones up, actually, which might indicate there's somebody buried there. Big giant sphere. Obviously designed to rotate. And it broke. That's clever. It broke, so they're using the motorbike. Keep it going. Clever. Cables. Follow the cables. Hang on. Oh, they went up. Oh, switch. It don't do nothing. What's this? Or whatever it is, it doesn't look like there's way in. Let's see where else we can go. Go around it. Whoa, hello. What do we have here? It's a map of some sorts, but not really. Oh, I think... Well, when he's talking about putting power back on, this probably lights up to show where the power is being supplied to, because this obviously looks like a power generator. There's lots of cables going in. Or maybe not a generator. There's cables going in. There's cables going out. There's cables going in. Cables going in mean electricity flowing from something else. From a train. Ah, there we go. Okay, so from a train, which means there must be a fuel intake, and that red pipe is the fuel. What's this? Caution, fuel drain. Okay, I don't want it being drained. I want it filling up fuel tank. Okay, let's follow the red pipe. There must be fuel somewhere. Okay, the black cable. Hose. Oh! Oh! Pump the gas. Pump fuel out of the tank underneath there. Anything else I can do here? There's something going on inside. Okay, that's just a little bit creepy. There's something in there getting power, but nowhere else. Oops. There we go. Spacebar takes photos. That's somewhat irritating, actually. So used to the spacebar being jump. Anything to do over here? Nope. 1971. There's a telephone box and nothing else. Nothing to do there. Yay! We have a full fuel tank. Okay, so let's turn it on. Nothing happened. Oh, hello. Ah! Prime and start. Start doesn't do anything. Let's try prime. Oh, this wee thing's filling up. Okay. Oh, this thing went orange. It wasn't orange before. Let's start. That's a nice sound. Okay, I can't do anything else over there now. That means that I must be able to ignore the fact that the train is now running. It will not run out of fuel. Okay, so power's on. Where did that circuit diagram go? There it is. Was I right about it? Oh, there's a hum! Lots of lights! Yes! Oh. Not everything's lit up though. Sphere, tower, tunnels, scrap. Farley, CW. CW must be the guy that I was speaking with earlier on. What's up here? A locked door? Okay. What is this? Just a sphere, but there's stairs inside. Where do they lead? They lead nowhere. So why is it here? Okay, it's part of a building there. There's a pathway. Probably can't reach that by now. That looks like a pathway along there. There's another sphere. Lots of things up there, and I can see into this scrapyard. There's lots of junk that they're just piling up. Okay, so the power's on. Isn't that what CW? I assume that's him. That's what he wanted, wasn't it? Let's go back and talk to him. Oh, does this do anything? Must do. Okay, so the sphere rotates. What's the significance of that? Because it doesn't seem to do anything when it doesn't have anything going on inside it, so. Let's go back and talk with CW. Oh, hello, let's go up these stairs. Let's see what's going on. Nothing. Just go up to here and then you can't do anything. Boring! Presumably that path gets connected later on. I would do by those stairs. There's a lever up there that obviously gets pulled at some point. Okay. Let's go and talk with CW. See what it is he's got to say.
Whatever it is, hands us in.
Okay, so I've got to turn off the red beam, but there's no way to interact with that. So there's got to be some other way to do it. How do I turn off the red beam? I can't get back there. Let's find another way to do it. Let's go and have a look. Does this door work? Ah! Let's go and have a look. Okay. Oh, not much to do there. Ah, it's the other side of those doors, and I've got a lot of things to move out of the way before I can get to that door. Backer reward item. Mayor's Imager requests. Entry Canyon, Farley's House, Centre of Town, Tree, Water Source. Okay, so I haven't looked at that one yet. Membrane wall cell, wall tower, locomotive power generator, scrapyard garage. Looks like those ones have not been done. Which makes sense since I didn't find any there. Ambassador Seed Swap Machine functionality. Radius of swap sphere is defined at first swap. Seeds recharge naturally from ubiquitous ambient membrane power radiation tied to the tree health. Forcing seed open triggers prep behaviour. Small battery added to amplify ambient membrane power. Parabolic focusing of power used to trigger seed swap behaviour. Locking location of swap machines assures predictability. No unanticipated damage. Radius demarcation also occurs at same location in destination sphere. Ah! Ah! So these spheres that I'm seeing around the landscape are transportation points of some description, and this little device, presumably on the inside, will swap or transport me from that one sphere to another somewhere else, and I can probably use these to get access to the parts of this area that I do not have access to. Without a pair seed defining the destination swap location, the destination coordinates match the source. Okay, so if there's no, if there's nowhere to transport to, I'm just going to stay where I am. Okay, right, that is useful information. What do we have here? Mofang solid volume projector. Dimensional projector produces solid apparitions with light volume and some sort of simulated mass. Ruko says all projectors will have similar power levels and communication protocols. There are three primary elements. Projector, control arm, communication arm. 7 volt communication level is a carrier voltage. Fangs have tuned the retrace timing to 30 Hz for us. Blah blah blah. Got a page. Image bounds. Ah, these are the devices that I'm seeing the mayor's image from. And the image device only creates an image, and they've added on a speaker to give it audio. Sound will be handled separately. Some projection noise, slight shimmer from radio interference. Moving image corruption noise toward bottom of projection. Images above projection arm bounds are possible. Checking for potential hidden lethality. Checks out, can't find anything destructive. Consistent, spurious, very high frequency background carrier. No idea what that could be. Odd side effect, projection intersecting any part of cell wall suppresses all transport. What? Alright, okay. Next page. Oh, it's blank. Okay, so not much in that book. Once again, Cyan proving that they need to use books in the game. I love that. Reading is an important part of a game. Disabler. Designed to disable anything based on Mofang technology. Now, wait a minute. He said the red beam was a Mofang device. Disables when blue beam is within about 1 hour. Ah! Physically collapsible. Reassembly is possible but non-trivial. Apra assures me that it's not harmful. Ruko has not been told that the villain's... Okay, so the blue beam at the entryway of this area is not lethal. I can walk through it. What's this? It's nothing. Okay. Another one. Lockdown list. Ah. So this is what they did to lock down the place, and to get it all open and running again, I should have to do the opposite. So I should be doing this in the opposite order. Activate the dome disabler. That's what I'm disabling now. Turn off power. I've turned it on. Divert river. I've undiverted it. Close the swing bridge. Oh, that's the thing I've... with the propeller, okay. Turn on imager rocks, that would be the rocks near the beginning where there's the sort of red glow. I see what's going on. I get you. I'm there. I need to do the opposite of all of them things. What's this little bit? Please change Farley's lock code to secure the vault. Her address backwards should suffice. Okay, so I'm going to need her house number. Oh, here's the blue device, the blue beam. Can I lower that somehow? There's a button. Buttons are good. Yes! Okay, I need to get that out and shoot the red beam with it, I think. I think that's what it would do. There's some things around there, let's go and have a look around there. Okay. So
all right, now move around.
This is about one.
Why are you so nervous? This is the
Okay, now what? don't think that's enough.
Okay, so that's them obviously testing these imagers. What's up here? Barbecue! Aha! Big plug. What is this? Work begins on battery power test, first charge 10%, blah blah. Okay, so that's obviously something that I'll need to look at later. I don't think that's going to do anything now. Oh, I wonder if that's what all these carts with the things in them are for. I reckon it must be. Oh, hello. Let's go along here. What can I do along here? I can't do anything along there because the track doesn't go. Or can I? Nope. No track below, no support, so no walking. Okay, what's this? Well, a water tank. Let's water the tree. Probably needs water. It's a dry place. It's a desert. Okay, so blue beam is not lethal. Makes a wicked noise, but it seems fine. Okay. There's really weird stuff going on there. Oh, hello. Enter. Yes, we'll go in here. Thank you. Ah. Okay, so W, A, S, and D control the direction of the beam. Nothing much to do with it. Let's turn it off. Can I go forwards? Nope. Backwards? Nope. How do I turn it? Whoa. Ah! You can either have the beam or forward and backward motion! Yes! Okay, but the problem is I want to disable that red beam. Can I do that from here? No, I can't. Right, okay, so I think what I need to do is get the car a bit further back. So let's do it. Whoa, hello. I'm not supposed to have a shadow, I turned it off in the settings. Let's try this. Let's turn that off so we can move backwards. No! I'm supposed to be... Oh man! Obviously it was set to go the right way and I turned it the wrong way. Right, let's get back inside. Hey. Yes, this looks like it could be good. This could work. Hello. Okay, that was freaky. But what have I done? Am I able to run through the wall now? Able to go through the wall? Let's go and find out. Doink, 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 doink. Pretty sure it was up here I saw the edge. Yeah, I'll just go through here. So yes, I can use this to my advantage, I think. It looks like, judging by where that white bit of light was that when I came through, is that wherever I go through, I reappear on the opposite edge. Is that what just happened? I don't know. Just guessing. Locked door. No surprise there. Obviously I need to get the cart here to get rid of those things. Okay, so we've learnt much and this video is now over 1 hour in length. And since there's no loading screens, I don't have to do really any editing. Way! So, thank you for watching. I hope I've piqued your interest in what Obduction's all about. We're going to continue playing this every so often for an hour. And we'll see how the videos work out. Until next time, bye for now.